Good morning, Honorable. Last time we saw about the applications of operation amplifier like scale changer, sign changer, and voltage follower. So today we are going to see about V2I converter and I2V converter. So here are the diagram of V2I converters. There are two types of V2I converters, floating load and grounded load. So in floating load, the basic structure is like this. So here the load is connected with the resistor R2. So we on floating point. So it is called as the floating load. So in grounded load, the load is connected to the grounded. So only it is called as the grounded load, V2I converter. Now we are going to see the formula for what is in the V2I converter. So first of all, V2I means we are going to convert the input voltage into the output current. So we are going to give the input as a voltage and we are going to convert it into output current. So from the node A, we are going to write the voltage value. So voltage at node A. So VVI or here we have our input voltage. So VI is equal to, so we know the formula for Ohm's law, that is V is equal to I into R. So here IL is the load current and R1 resistor. So IL into R1. So from this equation we can obtain IL load current R1, that is our output current. IL is equal to VI by R1. So this is our formula for floating load V2I converter. So next one is our grounded load V2I converter. Here we are connecting the resistor in the parallel form. So from the node V1 we are going to write the equation of KVL. So here we are going to take the current equation. So entering current is equal to leaving current. KVL, we are going to apply KVL, after that we are converted into KVL. So from the node V1, we are going to write, so the total current is IL. So IL is equal to sum of these two currents, I1 and I2. So I1 plus I2. So now we are going to apply the voltage KVL formula. So here the I1 current is going through the going from V into V1. So we are going to write VI minus V1 R, because I is equal to V by R. Because I is equal to V by R, so VI minus V1 by R plus, so I2 here is coming from V0 to VI, so V0 minus V1 by R. So separating the values, we can obtain the octave of equation. So VI by R minus V1 by R plus V0 by R minus V1 by R. We can add these two values here, V1 by R is V1 by R. So it is VI by R plus V0 by R. This is equal to 2 V1 by R. I am going to take this IL to this side. So minus IL. So this is, here I am going to take common as R. So we can get cancel the R value. So 2 V1 by R, here we are going to multiply R. So VI plus V0 minus IL R. So here R will cancel. So V1 is equal to equal to ILR. So from this equation we applied R, load current. So IL is equal to V by R. Hence it is true. R, hence the floating load as well as and log load are true. So from this we can say that V to I converter, the voltage, the input voltage will be converted into output current IL. So next we will see about I to V converter. Now we are going to see about I to V converter, which means we are going to give the input current and we are going to give the output voltage. So it is also called as trans resistance amplifier. The V to I converter is also called as transconductance amplifier. So here the input is virtually grounded. So there is no current going this through this resistor RS. So the current will be flows through the feedback resistor. So here IS current will flows through the feedback resistor. So we can simply we can say that output voltage V naught. That means V is equal to I into R. Here the current is IS into the resistor R. So IS into R. So here the input is connected towards the inverting terminal. So we are going to give the current as the negative terminal. So it is 40 degree phase shift of the input. Output will be 40 degree phase shift of the input value. So this is our I to V converter formula. So the application of I to V